This next question is a very common question I get from patients. How should I approach fat bombs? Are they a snack or are they an addition to a meal?
So again, I'm going to go back to that frustrating answer first, which is it depends. It can be very individual. And so for some people, it's a great snack. For other people, they can have it as part of a sweet treat right at the end of the meal, but you have to be really cautious. And remember this, fat is fantastic. We know that we need to have a larger percentage of fat in our diet, but fat is not a free food. So just because something is containing even exclusively fat does not mean more is better. So we have to police things even like a fat bomb. So I'd say work with your health coach on this to find out what's going to be the right amount or cadence, like every day, do I do this every other day? Is this a once a week treat for me? Depending on how your body is reacting. And then really, you know, how is it best for you? Is it one fat bomb in the afternoon and I'm great until I can get home and have time to prepare dinner? Because for some people, that may be the perfect place to put a fat bomb. For other people, they're done with dinner, but they just want that small bite of something sweet and they make a small fat bomb. For that person, that may also be perfect too. So again, individualized on this, but remember, fat is not a free food.
I think that's an important point as well, because it's very easy to overdo those fat bombs. And then while you may have amazing ketones, your weight is probably going to stall as well. So they can definitely go a little too far if you're not careful. So that personalization piece is very important.